Hello YouTube, this is Loud Styles and this is Loudon's World. Today on Loudon's World, I'm going to run down all of the matches and give you my thoughts on what happened on WWE Hell in a Cell. Was it good? Was it bad? What was WWE thinking? All that. First match I want to talk about is the triple threat matchup between John Morrison, Daniel Bryan, and The Miz for the United States Championship in a submissions-only Falls Count Anywhere match. First ever time this match has been made, and it's, you know, a first. The basic rules of the match was you can only win by submission, and you can do it anywhere. Now, going into this matchup, Daniel Bryan already had the advantage because of the fact that he is a technical wrestler, great submission expert, and he had a one-up on everyone. Now, it was already noted that Daniel came into this match already fired up and pretty much, you know, wanted to get his hands on Miz and everyone, and long story short, Daniel Bryan retains the United States Championship by making The Miz tap out yet again. You know, you can say what you want about Daniel Bryan, but he is the future of that company, like I said. I mean, a lot of people just don't like him. It's their, you know, their reason why, but I believe he's proven himself in this matchup. I believe he's proven himself in this triple threat match that he's, you know, good. And Morrison, you know, he had a good showing, and so did The Miz. But Daniel came out the victor and won the matchup. The next match, which was an obvious one, was Randy Orton versus Sheamus. I had a feeling Randy was going to win the match, and he did. He beat Sheamus in Hell in a Cell, and that's about it. I mean, he destroyed Sheamus. God. The other match was Kane versus The Undertaker. Paul Bearer on Undertaker's side inside Hell in a Cell for the World Heavyweight Championship. So, here's a question. Who did not see Paul Bearer help Kane out? Who did not see that coming? I'm sorry, but I had a feeling that Paul Bearer was going to screw The Undertaker. I had a feeling he would do that. Because if they're pushing Kane to be the dominant brother, then, of course, you know, they're going to give Undertaker this, you know, oomph and then take it from him. I mean, they're pushing Kane to be the dominant brother, so even though I kind of was shocked to see Paul Bearer back, and I was like, oh, he's going to go back to being that Taker thing, I was kind of not surprised that they would do that. I really wasn't. And then Edge versus Jack Swagger. It was like an impromptu matchup. Edge kind of is going into a face turn, I think. I mean, now, he's going through this whole epic quest of taking out everything in WWE that is deemed stupid. So, his first victim was Jack Swagger, and he beat Jack in the match, and Edge seemingly is having a face turn. So, Edge is turning face again. Let's hope for this time it actually is for good, because seeing a face Edge is actually an interesting thing. Then the matchup everybody was just waiting to see. John Cena versus Wade Barrett. If John loses, he has to join Nexus. If John wins, Nexus is disbanded. Now, here's a question for you all. You have John Cena, the poster boy for WWE. He is the face of WWE. And then you have the Nexus, a group that seemingly is doing really good, and you don't want to give up either of the two. You don't want to disband Nexus because that's like the best thing WWE's ever done. And you don't want to get rid of John Cena because, well, he's the face of WWE. So what do? You make John Cena join the Nexus. Now, I'm not saying that's a bad thing because, God, that is like the best thing I've ever heard in my entire life. John Cena joins the Nexus. That is such a swerve to me because I figured, you know, Nexus is going to disband because there's no chance in hell that they'll let John Cena lose a match. Guess what? Cena lost a match, and he has to join Nexus. So, everybody's little fantasy has finally come true. John Cena joins the Nexus. And what's so funny about it is that I've had, myself and a few others have always said that it's going to come down to where there's going to be a stipulation where John Cena has to join the Nexus. And it's happened. Cena is now a member of the Nexus. Everybody's favorite superhero, the last dying son of Krypton, is now in the Nexus. Oh man. I can hear the Cena fans weeping right now. Overall, the whole entire pay-per-view was good. It was, I mean, the matches were good. Some were just not that great. I mean, the only matches I really paid attention to were Orton and Sheamus, Daniel Morrison and Miz, and Barrett and Cena. I didn't even really pay much attention to the Undertaker Kane match, though that was a really brutal matchup. I didn't pay much attention to it. But I did pay attention to the other three matches because those were the ones that piqued my interest. Any match that involves Daniel Bryan pretty much piques my interest because I think Daniel's just a great competitor. A lot of people say that he's not because he doesn't really, his style doesn't fit in WWE. I beg to differ because Evan Bourne's in WWE and God knows everybody that his style doesn't fit because, you know. But we're not going to get into that. Anyway, those are my thoughts. Leave your comment under this video and tell me what you think of my thoughts on Hell in a Cell. I'm Louden Styles. I'm over. I'm out. And I am gone.